Moonhack, for those who haven't done it before, is a big coding event that we run every year. And we try to get as many kids coding as possible. And this year, we've got 6 different projects that you can do as part of Moonhack. And we're going to run through one of them today. And the one we're doing today, I built with my friend Rami, who you're about to meet. And it's all about space junk and getting rubbish out of space. So, Rami, would you like to tell us some more about who you are and what space junk is?
Okay, thanks, Nicola. So today I'm going to share a little bit about what about the science about space rubbish is. So just like you, I'm also a student. I'm actually studying these special kinds of stars called pulsars. They are very massive stars that have exploded a very long time ago. And I study them using a very big telescope called the Parkes Radio Telescope. The Parkes Radio Telescope is located in New South Wales, and it's so big you can actually fit an Olympic pool inside it. It's 64 metres wide, so it's quite big. I also love taking photos of space. I took all these photos of space from my backyard. And what you can see here are the planets Jupiter and Saturn, a sun, a galaxy, a moon, and some stars as well. Next slide, please. So, using the chat function, can a few of you maybe tell me what you think this is? So, Ms. Gerhardt said it's a galaxy. Anyone else got any answers as well? Oh, someone wrote it's junk around Earth. Very good. Yeah, another galaxy. Yeah, that's very good. Awesome. Okay, so actually, we might actually go to the next screen and I'll tell you guys what it is. It is actual, it's satellites around the Earth. And if you look at the actual Earth there in the middle, you can see a whole bunch of satellites that are actually orbiting near the Earth. So those satellites that are actually near the Earth are in low Earth orbit. And we actually use our satellites for some of our communications and looking at what's happening on the Earth. Now, there's a bigger ring of satellites, as you can see, out at geostationary orbit. And they're actually a large amount of satellites out there to actually monitor our weather, to keep the news going between different countries, and to keep our communications open as well. So how does all this space material, how does all this space junk actually get into space? So we might go to the next slide, please, Nicola. Okay, so there's a couple of stages here. Now what happens is for things to get into space, we need rockets. And for rockets go up from the Earth and they launch little satellites or other objects into space. Now, part of those rockets, the shell that takes the satellite up to space, sometimes they go up and part of it falls back down to Earth harmlessly in parachute or wherever it may be. As you can see with that green arrow, they come back down to Earth and we clean up on Earth. Sometimes they get a little bit higher. When they get higher, they come back down to Earth and they burn up through our atmosphere. And so they harmlessly do no damage to them, they just disappear, which is that yellow arrow and that lightning bolt. But sometimes they get so high that they just stay in space. And what happens is we get a lot of this junk, this lot of rubbish that keeps floating around in space and doesn't come back down for a very, very long time. And you can see with those little red arrows that I've drawn on the actual diagram, those arrows are the space junk. They keep floating in space. They don't come back down to Earth like the green arrow or the yellow arrow. Now, what happens is eventually, all that space junk builds up. And we've been launching rockets into space for about 60 years now, since the 1950s. And over time, a lot more and more of those little rocket pieces keep floating around in space and they keep actually becoming more risky for us all. Now, the reason why it's risky for us all is because we use space so much. You might not know it, but we use space so much. Right now, this conversation is using satellite technology and internet technology that's beaming around through satellites in space and coming back down to Earth. When we do our banking, we use space and satellite technology. When we walk around with our phones, our maps on our phones are pretty much satellite technology based. So anything that goes on in space really impacts us here on Earth as well. Next slide, please, Nicola. Now, the reason why it's really risky for having lots of space junk out there, lots of rubbish in space, is because all these things are floating around in space and eventually some of them do collide with each other. And when they collide with each other, they create more rubbish and more rubbish keeps colliding with each other. And eventually there's going to be so much rubbish out there colliding with each other that there's not going to be any room to have any valuable material up there, like satellites that do communication. Now in space, things are moving really, really fast. In fact, they're moving at about 28,000 kilometers an hour to stay in space. And that's super fast when you think about it. Now, a single speck of paint moving that fast can actually do a lot of damage. It acts like a bullet. So you can imagine how lots of space junk and rocket pieces will actually be behaving, and you wouldn't want any of them to actually, you know, knock into you as well. Now, when we actually start going into space, when humans start going into space, which we're seeing more and more of, be careful that none of this space junk, none of this space rubbish is around flying around and, you know, about to go into A, humans, or B, the rockets that actually take us up and bring us back down to space, because that's very unsafe for us. So we have to start thinking a bit more sustainably about how we actually now move into space as a species, as humans. How do we, or when we start going to space in rockets, how do we make it much more cleaner and less polluting when we go into space itself? So what are some things that we can actually do that makes space more sustainable? How can we think about before we launch our rockets, how do we think about before we go up into space, how do we make space less polluted and more sustainable? So there's a couple of options here, and some very exciting things that are happening in the space industry around the world at the moment. So on the right-hand side of that obvious image, you can see two rockets. Now, they look like they're going up, but these rockets are actually coming back down. And what happened was when these rockets launched, this is a real photo, by the way, when these rockets launched, they actually took their payload into space. They took the satellites into space and they came back down and they both landed together. It looked like a bit of a sci-fi movie, actually. It's quite fun. And that's really sustainable because it means that all the rocket pieces that you see there are no longer floating in space. Instead, they're coming back down to Earth and we can reuse them. Now, another option is on the top left-hand side, you can see a little robot-like claw, which is about to grab another satellite. Now, what we could do is we could build rubbish trucks that go to space, and these rubbish trucks have claws. And if there's something like an old satellite that doesn't work anymore, or one that's, you know, that's been broken, a rubbish truck can go and grab the actual old satellite and, you know, take it back down to Earth or take it to a higher orbit, which actually means it won't pose any risk. And lastly, the other thing we can do is we can actually send things back through our atmosphere. Now, remember I said things in space are moving really fast at 28,000 kilometers an hour. When you send something back into the atmosphere at that speed, it actually heats up because the atmosphere is moving past it so fast and it burns up harmlessly. And so we can get rid of space rubbish by burning it in the high atmosphere, and it does no damage to our atmosphere as well. Cool. So this is a photo from the space station at nighttime. And you can see all those lights are actually cities. The bright spots are the bigger cities and the smaller spots are small towns. And across the top, the very top left-hand side, you can see the Northern Lights, which is the Aurora Borealis, which is a geomagnetic storm that's caused by the sun. Now, what I wanted to really sort of showcase here in this photo, I think it's a very beautiful photo, by the way, but what I want to show in this photo is that it actually is a wonderful photo. It shows there's no borders and there's no countries, and it's just one global people. When we all move into space, we want to be able to think that way as well. So we can't be thinking that space is just for one person or for one country. It's for everyone, and we've got to be very respectful and sharing and very sustainable when you do move into space. And as I said, we want to be actually going into space and we don't want to have this scenario where there's all this space junk floating around, especially when we send humans up there. We want it to make it nice and clean and so everyone can use space. So today we're going to learn how to code a fun game about grabbing some space junk, like that little satellite image I showed you, and a space rock. And we're going to either send it back down to Earth and burn it up through our atmosphere, or we're going to send it down safely back down to Earth.
Thank you so much, Rami, for all your help teaching us about space junk. We had the best time. Now, if you want to keep going and do the Moonhack Space Junk project, just head here to moonhack.com. Head to the Starter Project tab and scroll down to Scratch Space Cleanup. In there, you'll find all the instructions to build your own space cleanup project using Scratch. And don't forget, if you've got any questions for Rami about space junk or for us at Code Club about Moonhack, don't forget to get in touch on Twitter or Facebook using these links. And last thing, don't forget to register your participation in Moonhack 2020 here at moonhack.com with the help of a parent or guardian. Thanks, guys.